I hope it is visible.
It is.
Oh, thank you very much. So I'll be making a presentation which is focused on sharing the status update on the WASH towards cholera elimination in Zambia. Greetings from Zambia to everyone. So the slide there is showing us the location of Zambia on the left. Zambia is in the southern part of Africa, surrounded by 8 neighbors. And on the right side, the red is showing us the cholera hotspots, which have high priority, and also the yellow and the green. When you look at that map, you are going to observe that most of the hotspots are in the central part of Zambia, going to the south and also extreme north. About 3.5 million people in Zambia live in cholera hotspots. And this is attributed to lack of access to adequate clean, safe water, poor sanitation, poor hygiene, and poor solid waste management practices. And this is the, as a result of that, we find ourselves in situations where there is open defecation, overcrowding at shared latrines, overflowing of latrines when there are floods, and health and hygienic conditions, illegal waste dumping, and also lack of adequate water for hand washing. Now, in order to eliminate cholera in Zambia by 2025, a number of interventions are being done. One of them is we want to ensure that there's universal access to clean and safe water and adequate sanitation and hygiene services for all the people, especially those in hotspots to start with. Then secondly, to embark on a reform process for WASH and solid waste management that includes enacting laws to strengthen the policy and regulatory framework, and also to provide clear policy direction. Thirdly, to provide a framework that is responsive to the sustainable development goals, especially those focusing on water and sanitation, SDG number 6. Then address public health, environmental and climate change adaptation and mitigation. Now, in order to practically put what we are saying to, on the ground, we are saying we are undertaking a lot of projects. And these projects, which I'm going to showcase here, are those which are targeting the hotspots. Remember, we did the hotspot mapping, and we know our hotspots, and we know where we have to start from. The first one is the emergency works in Perabun cholera hotspots in Lusaka. And the amount which is focusing on the hotspot is 4.5 million. Of course, this project is more than this, but I'm bringing out the cost for hotspots and also the number of beneficiaries. In Lusaka, it's one of the areas where there are hotspots, especially in the peri-urban areas, as presented in the first presentation. So here we can see a borehole which was done, and now on the right side, an elevated tank is also being constructed. And further on the left hand side, we have a reservoir and a booster station, and on the right, we have the pumps to ensure that everybody receives clean, safe, and adequate water all the time. Then we also have the Kafue bulk water supply project. This is a huge project, but the component which is going to directly impact on those people in the hot spots is $7 million, and it will benefit over 200,000 people. On the right, left, we have infrastructure being done. We have an old water intake and a new one being constructed. Then just next, we have pipes being laid to get water 65 kilometers from Lusaka town to Lusaka in order to improve the water supply. On the right, we have Mbala. Mbala is on the north part of Zambia, where it's a cholera hotspot. We had the serious cholera in 2018 there, including Lusaka. So in view of that, we are doing the Mbala water supply and sanitation project at a cost of 1 million and benefiting 80,000 people. Then these interventions are not restricted to very urban areas. They have also gone to rural areas. And in rural areas, we use two models. One, the small pipe water schemes in growth centers, and also we also use the boreholes and other interventions. So here we are showcasing on the left, from left to right, we have a borehole there. And when you pump water from that industrial borehole, it goes in the elevated tank, which is a second depiction on top. Then we're able to distribute from the draw points there. That is where communities draw from. That is why we have two taps. But on the lower part, the left side, we also have standpipes where people can draw. We put these in institutions and public places, and even at individual places. The one in the middle at the bottom is a borehole. This is commonly used, but we have realized that it is not very easy to use that method because it takes a lot of energy. On the right, we are trying to also encourage the use of solar to pump water and distribute as a way to save many people at once. Then on the north in Incherenge, we have a big refugee settlement, Mantapara refugee settlement, where refugees from Democratic Republic of Congo come into Zambia. And you know, cholera is also there in Congo, it's here in Zambia. And so in order to prevent that, we have ensured that water and sanitation facilities are put up there. This has been with support from partners, the German government and the UNICEF and the government of Zambia. Then we are also undertaking rehabilitation of non-functional boreholes in Incherenge and other places. You can see on the left, that is a dilapidated borehole. In the middle, it's the same. And on the right, we have a team of technical people working on that. Then we are not only talking about water supply, we're also looking at sanitation and hygiene. So on the left top, we are saying that is a new facility from the OT. Those are put at public places in institutions such as schools and the healthcare facilities. The same with that one in the middle. And on the right top, that is what we find inside. We want to ensure that we provide adequate sanitation. On the bottom, in communities, rural communities, we encourage people to build their own sanitation facilities using local available material. And in order to do that, we undertake what we call behavioral change activities. One of them is community-led total sanitation, where we trigger people in order to realize the benefits of having a toilet and using a toilet and the cost of not having the same. So these are working very well. Then further, we have Kaputa Water Supply Project, which was earlier alluded to. Also have Nkirenge, Chienge Water Supply Sanitation Projects. The costs are shown there, and also the people who are benefiting. These are in hotspots, and also Mpulungu, and also Chongwe Water Supply Projects. All these are addressing the issues of water supply in cholera hotspots. Then we are also constructing a lot of piped water schemes in hotspots. For example, Nkirenge and Mwese, Nsama, Mpulungu, and other districts. This is an addition to the usual provision of water to all the people of Zambia. We are also drilling boreholes in hotspots 302, and these have been equipped with the hand pumps. We have also rehabilitated 429 functional boreholes in the cholera hotspots, which were mentioned earlier, the 11, these Tambo, Kapira, and so on. And we have benefited a total of 75,000 people for water, 105 people for sanitation. And further, we have done, constructed institutional sanitation facilities, 760 in the cholera hotspots. Of course, we have done more, but these numbers are for cholera hotspots. We have also done, as I said earlier, behavioral change activities, community-related sanitation, sanitation marketing, and hygiene interventions to over 700,000 people at the cost of 2.16 million. These are funds from partners, the government, and others. Now, we are not ending there. We are also looking at improving WASH in healthcare facilities in Zambia, and we have achieved the following. Baseline data for the WASH in healthcare facilities was done, and the following documents were developed for WASH in healthcare facilities: standards and technical guidelines, national technical assessment tools, water quality monitoring protocols, and we have also conducted water quality monitoring gap analysis. Strong collaboration, advocacy, and resource mobilization for WASH in healthcare facilities is equally strong. All these are meant to strengthen the healthcare facilities in order to help eliminate cholera. Other achievements: water supply sanitation policy was launched in 2020. Open Defecation Strategy was launched in 2018 and is being implemented. And the government of Zambia has demonstrated this commitment to achieve the targets set in the multi-sectoral cholera elimination plan by financing many WASH interventions in cholera hotspots, though we still need to increase the budget allocation for WASH, particularly the cholera elimination plan. Further, we have challenges. The risk profile for WASH in hotspots has not been done. So it's an appeal we are making that we need to be supported to do the risk preferring for all hotspots, cholera hotspots, so that we know exactly which interventions would work faster. Next, we are looking at inadequate investment in WASH and solid waste management. For example, you see that even when we look at support from our major partners, WHO, we have done more in oral OVC support, but WASH still lags behind. Then COVID-19 has also negatively affected the WASH sector, and some of the gains were somehow lost, but with support from partners, we are trying to hold in there. Then inadequate partner support to WASH. We encourage more support by partners to WASH with specifically calling for hotspots. Recommendations, we want to conduct a risk assessment for WASH in all cholera hotspots, continue long-term investments because that is more sustainable as it is preventive. Then develop a financing mechanism, strengthen partner coordination for scaling of WASH interventions, and strengthen and continue resource mobilization through partner mapping. Finally, what have we achieved? We are saying so far, a total of $32.05 million US dollars has been committed and is being utilized for WASH towards the elimination of cholera in hotspots. And that represents 47.2% of our budget for WASH. But this is not adequate because if you look at our targets, we need to have this investment. We are supposed to have, we need more than this where we have reached here. And also what we are saying, a total of 1,485,000 people who benefit once the interventions are completed. And that will represent 42.42% of the targeted population of 3.5 million people living in cholera hotspots. What we are saying further is that it is important for us to look at the long-term measures of cholera elimination. That is why we want wherever all of cholera vaccination has been done, we should follow with WASH, which is going to be permanent. Otherwise, commitment is there, and working together, we have been able to achieve. Thank you very much.